folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today we're going to be chatting about the EVH D-Tuna. What it is, how to use it, and why it's one of the best things to ever happen to the world of electric guitar. In the simplest of terms, the EVH D-Tuna is a little device created and crafted by our Lord and Savior, my personal idol, Mr. Edward Van Halen, to drop the low string of a double locked-in Floyd Rose tremolo system down from an E to a D, to save them having to switch guitars live, or us now to switch guitars live, or, you know, it's a faff when you've got one of these double locking Floyd Rose style tremolo systems and you want to change the tuning, even just standard to drop D. You've got to get the toolkit out, you've got to get the Allen keys out, undo all these nuts up here, tune up down here, retune the fine tuners down there. It's a bit of a faff and it takes a bit of time. With the D tuner though, Ed made it so easy for us to enjoy this fantastic thing, and I wholly believe it's one of the greatest inventions to ever happen to the world of guitar. However, if you've never used one before, it can be quite daunting, because unless you know how to set it up, it can go a bit awry and go a bit strange. So in this video, we're going to talk about that's kind of how it is, how it operates, and how to set your guitar up so the D-Tuna works perfectly. I will say, just starting off, the D-Tuna was created to work with Floyd Rose tremolo systems, or licensed, official Floyd Rose tremolo systems. So, the EVH ones, obviously, the Floyd Rose Pro, all the way down to the Special. When you start delving into the world of like the Ibanez Edges and other double-locking tremolo systems, which do the same thing as a Floyd Rose, but aren't Floyd Rose systems, mechanically, they're not designed to work with the Floyd, because Ed wanted it to work with his guitar, which had a Floyd on, so they're kind of only designed for licensed Floyd Rose tremolo systems. And of course, because it's an EVH branded product, you're obviously going to find it on a lot of EVH branded guitars, with the Wolfgang's Specials going upwards. Got the 5150 standard series, the EVH Frankie has it on, and lots of different guitars like that. But you'll also find it in Charvels, in Kramers and stuff from the factory, because it is an EVH branded product, but it's not specific to work with EVH guitars. It's anything with that licensed Floyd Rose tremolo system, and with that you can buy it off the shelf to retrofit it yourself to your guitar with a Floyd Rose, like I've done to pretty much all bar one of my guitars with a Floyd Rose. Like my main Kramer, you might have seen in some videos, that's got a cool little brown one on. Even my old 87 Pacer Custom has got one on, and I've kind of took all the body out to make it fit. I don't recommend doing that, but you can do a lot with them. Well, you can do one thing with them, but what you can do with them is great. Actually, touching on my old Pacer here, they work the best of their ability to guitars that have top-mounted Floyd Rose systems. So the ones that don't pull up and they only go down. Either block off a fully floating one so it only goes down, or like the Wolfgang's where it's just resting on the top of the body. And that's because, one, obviously it sticks quite far out the back and you won't be able to pull it up with the standard the routing underneath the Floyd Rose floating tremolo system. Like, or you can just cut a big hole out like I did on this, because Nuno Bettencourt did that as well and I wanted to be cool like him, so I copied that with this. But also with the way the tensions work, unless it's flat against the body and the springs on the back are pulling the Floyd Rose in, when it's floating and you reduce the tension from an E to a D on a fully floating trem, the rest of the strings do go ever so slightly sharp or flat. You can obviously tweak it, like this works fine, but it's not as instant as a top-mounted, only goes down in pitch Floyd Rose system. I think that kind of makes sense. So it will work floating up if you cut a big chunk out and pull it up, but you will have to tweak it a bit more than a standard one. So how does a D-Tuna work then? How does it switch back and forth between D and E to D so easy? Essentially, the D-Tuna is just a wedge or a shim, essentially, which slots in between the fine tuning screw and the string locking screw that goes in the back of the Floyd Rose system, goes into the saddle and pushes the little block, you know, the little block up against your string to clamp it in. When you get a Floyd Rose D-Tuna equipped guitar, or you buy a D-Tuna by itself to retrofit to your Floyd Rose, it will come with a longer screw to replace the string locking screw that goes into the saddle. So the wedge of the D-Tuna, when it's engaged, when it's pressed in to go to standard tuning, sits in between the fine tuning screw coming down and the saddle locking screw that goes in through the back there. And that's because the way these fine tuners work and the way you can fine tune the guitar after it's been locked in here at the headstock is because these fine tuning screws apply downward pressure to the string locking screws, altering their pitch pretty much. And you can tell that just by even pressing down on the screws at the back there. That's when you press it in, it goes sharp. increasing the tension of the string, making it go sharp, and obviously when you pull the fine tuner out, it goes flat, reducing the tension of the string. And the D-Tuna is perfectly designed to have the perfect shape, the perfect mass to go in between the fine tuner at the top and the string locking screw to perfectly pitch it up from D to E. And with that, it's a common misconception to think that when the D-Tuna is engaged, you go to D-tuning, because that's kind of how it sounds, EVH D-Tuna. No, actually when it's engaged, you're in standard tuning. When you disengage it, you pull it out, making the original string locking screw touch the fine tuner. You're in drop D. So it's kind of backwards in that sense. And with that, a lot of people don't realize the way to perfectly, firstly, set up your D-tuner is to obviously undo the locking screws up top and then tune as if your guitar is gonna solely stay in drop D. So set it up and lock it in and stretch the strings and everything in drop D with the D-tuner out and disengaged. So the fine tuner is just pressing against the string locking screw that goes in the back there. And try and have the little fine tuner as far out as you can to give you more room to move the D-tuner back and forth. Obviously it can come out a little bit for a little bit of fine tuning if you want to do it every now and then, but it can be a bit of a press sometimes if you're too far down, and when you're too far in, sometimes it can actually press against the body, making the whole bridge system raise up. Again, knocking your guitar totally out of whack. So once you've got your guitar, your Floyd Rose Cup guitar, all locked in and fine-tuned up in drop D, engage the fine-tuner. And a lot of the time, like I said, it will give you the perfect amount off the bat. You rarely kind of stray away a bit. It'll be the perfect D to E, not E to D, D to E. But sometimes it can be a little bit off. And that's why Ed thought of the clever idea of putting a little grub screw or setting screw on the side of the D-tuner. Hope you can see a picture of it up there. And what you do with this is get an even smaller Allen key. It comes with all these Allen keys. And when the D-tuner is engaged in, if you're a little bit sharp or flat, you can either raise or lower the pitch. By tightening or loosening that little grub screw. It's like a fine tuner for the D-tuner. So it's perfect when it's out, and when you press it in, if it is a little bit off, you can slacken it off to make it flatter or tighten it up to make the tone a bit sharper, because when you tighten it up, it actually presses the little screw, the little grub screw, into the bigger locking saddle screw, therefore making the D-tuner move up and down, making the pitch higher or lower. So with the little grub screw, set screw, fine tuner on the side of the D-tuner itself, I'd recommend before you install it, make sure it's halfway in or out of the side of the D-tuner. Just so you've got a bit of wiggle room to go sharp or flat. It's as easy as that. So in a nutshell, the D-tuner is a device for the low E string, the sixth string of your electric guitar, to drop it, no, to raise it, let's say, from D to E. And it does that by being a little wedge going in between the fine tuner screw up top and the string locking screw that goes into the back of the little saddle, which clamps your string in on your Floyd Rose system. It will only work on a Floyd Rose system or a licensed Floyd Rose system. And when it comes to setting it up, make sure you set your guitar up in D, make sure it's pulled all the way out, all the way out. Set it up in D, drop D of whatever tuning you're in. It can be standard, E flat, or whatever. Drop D and then lock everything up, stretch everything in, then engage it, plug it in so you're in standard tuning again, or whatever tuning you're in. And then fine tune it with a little grub screw on the side of the D tuner. If you are having trouble disengaging it and engaging it, you find it a bit stiff and stuff, and sometimes you might have to like lower the bar to then get it in. When it comes to setting it up, make sure the fine tuner is further out the next time you do it than it was previously when you did it, when it gets stuck, because that's what it's getting stuck between. The maximum lowness, let's say, of the locking screw down the back there and the fine tuner up top. So when you first set it up, make sure the fine tuner is all the way out if you're having trouble disengaging it. For something so simple, it is quite complex, but I absolutely love it. Let me know what you think down below in the comments about the D-tuner. I've tried to make this as simple as I can, because it is a simple concept. Pull it out for low tuning, press it in for higher tuning, but it is quite, I suppose it can get quite complex when you delve a bit further into it. So if you have any more questions, please comment down below, and I'll try and answer them as quickly and as as best as I can for the D-Tuna. It's a fantastic piece of kit, and I love it a bit. In the description box as well down below, you can buy yourself a D-Tuna from PMT Online, as we say EVH, from PMTOnline.co.uk, and check out all of our D-Tuna Crypt guitars, which are all linked down there too. We are playing music today on all social media platforms. I've been Dagan. It's been a pleasure. I'll see you next time.